hydrosphere. In our previous session, we learnt about what exactly is our environment all about, where we studied the various components of our environment and also the four spheres. Friends, do you know something? If you view our planet Earth from the space, it looks blue, as major part of the Earth's surface is covered with water. And this is the reason why Earth is known as water planet or blue planet. And this abundance of water is what distinguishes Earth from other planets of our solar system. Let's know some more things about this interesting feature of our Earth, that is our hydrosphere. We all know all the water on the surface, below the ground and surrounding the Earth comes under hydrosphere. We can also see water in different forms, like in rivers, seas, oceans, snow, rain, glaciers, ice caps, etc. Here, if we observe, water is present in solid form in glaciers, snow and ice caps, whereas it exists in liquid form in rivers, seas, oceans and rainfall. Now, can water be present in gaseous state? Friends, we all have seen the steam coming out from the boiling water. This steam is water in its gaseous state. So we can say water exists in all three states of matter: solid, liquid, and gas. Now, if we look at the distribution of water in different forms on our Earth, 71% of our Earth is covered with water and the remaining 29% is land. And around 97% of this water is in seas and oceans. And so we call this water as marine water or saline water, as it has more amount of dissolved salts and so it's not fit for drinking. And the remaining 3% is fresh water. Here we call it as fresh water because the dissolved salt content is very less, and that is the reason why it is fit for drinking. And of the total fresh water, major part is locked in glaciers and ice caps, followed by underground water, and just a small amount is located in rivers and lakes. So we can compare this small portion of water which is available for drinking with the total water available on the Earth. And this is the reason why we must put efforts in conserving water. Here I remember the lines from the rhymes of ancient mariner: water, water everywhere, but not a drop to drink. It stands true completely in case of our planet Earth, as we have seen just now that a vast majority of our Earth's surface is covered by water, but only a small portion of it is fit for drinking. Water plays a crucial role in survival of living organisms on Earth. Where there is water, there is life. It is not just the Earth that is majorly covered with water. But do you know, water makes up approximately 70% of humans' body weight. An average person could live without food for nearly a month, but it would just be difficult for us to survive even for a week without water. That's how important water is to human life. Now let's move ahead and look how water acts as a resource to us. We call water as an important resource as we use it for various purposes, and we can divide this into three different uses, like agricultural use, domestic use and industrial use. We all know that crops require water for their growth, and we provide this water to our fields by proper irrigation facilities. Talking about the domestic use, it simply implies water which is required for household purposes, like drinking, washing, cooking, watering plants, etc. This water reaches to our homes through various distribution systems. And talking about industries, they require a huge amount of water at various levels of operations. Friends, we saw here that water has many different uses. But does all this water get exhausted as we use it? If that is the case, then how is this percentage of water on the earth maintained? Water is replenished or recycled through a natural process, which is called water cycle, which we will be studying in our coming session. So, to know more details about hydrosphere, please subscribe. If you have liked our session, please hit like and do leave your valuable comments. Thank you.